Hey Glam Squad, it's Jamie, the owner and CEO of Glam Event Rental, back with another video. So today what I'm going to be doing is chocolate covered strawberries, and I'm going to be honest with y'all, I do this for my family. I've never done this like on a professional level or anything like that, so just bear with me. I'm going to show you my method and how I do it, so stay tuned. Okay, so the first thing you want to do is make sure that your strawberries are clean. So I already washed my strawberries and they have to be completely dry too. You can't have any moisture or water at all on the strawberries or else your chocolate is going to seize up and it's not going to work. You want to try to find strawberries that are like similar in shape and size. So I'm actually going to be doing two of these. This is for Mother's Day actually. I'm doing one for my mom and then one for my aunt. I'm gonna do 12 strawberries for each of them, and I'm actually gonna put it together as a bouquet, but I'll show you that at the end. I've already picked out 12 strawberries. I'm just gonna start out with the first 12, and I'm gonna take you guys through doing the first bouquet, and then I'll just show you pictures of both of them once I'm done. So I'm gonna be using vanilla flavor almond bark. The reason I'm using almond bark is because it actually is easier to use versus white chocolate. And I'm gonna be adding some food coloring to it too, because they're gonna be two different colors. I'm gonna do white and pink. I just got the Great Value brand from Walmart, so nothing fancy or anything like that. So you wanna start off by opening it up and then putting this in the microwave. I use a coffee mug to do mine just because it's easier when it comes to dipping the strawberries and stuff. So you just wanna warm it up in a microwave in 30-second increments. And then you wanna just keep doing it in 30-second increments until it's completely melted. So I'm gonna pop these in the microwave and then I'll come back and show you. Okay, so this should be like the consistency of the almond bark. You just wanna make sure that you don't overheat it or anything like that. Now that we have that melted, I'm gonna go ahead and put my strawberries on the skewers. I just got these from Walmart too. These are 10-inch bamboo skewers. Okay, so we got that done. So I'm gonna be doing two different colors. We're gonna be doing white and pink. So I'm gonna do the white ones first and get those out the way. I just got this from Dollar Tree. It's just some floral foam. This is what I'm gonna use to stand the strawberries up on after I dip them. To put together the flower bouquet, but before I get into that, I did want to expand on a couple of things that I mentioned earlier in the video. So I do use a coffee cup to melt my chocolates down, because the coffee mug actually holds heat, so the chocolate stays warm for longer, so you have more time to work with your chocolate before it starts to cool down. The other thing that I wanted to explain is why I use almond bark versus chocolate. Chocolate has a thicker consistency and almond bark is a lot thinner, so it's easier to work with when you're dipping fruit. So anyway, back to the bouquet. What I'm doing is just taking my strawberries and sticking the skewer inside of this floral foam that I purchased from Dollar Tree. And the floral foam is just glued inside of this flower pot, which is also from Dollar Tree. Basically, everything that I used from this point on to the end of the video, I got from Dollar Tree.
Spirit is on us. Spirit of thunder. God's time. Keep it on the wrist. Junior wanna have me I'm outside in an AMG, right outside, TT, two-turn baby girl, you know me, still with the dolls that I grew beside, all the niggas round me, hide and they die, gotta watch the time cause it's flying right by, I'm outside in an AMG, right outside, TT, two-turn baby girl, you know me. Caught a shorty off a fence, dog. Just the one I'm really, it's a cringe, dog. Way that I've been living, I'm conventional. I'm just trying to make it to the end, you know. Certain things have started getting tense, dog. Think we need to have a sun adventure. I could be a man, but maybe down the road. Right now, I would rather see my heart turn to bone. Rather see my heart turn crystal. Right now I'm just stuck inside a crib on my own. Soon as I free up, I'm about to pop up on your phone. Like I'm outside in an AMG, right outside, PT. Two-turn baby girl, you know me. Who am I? All the niggas round me, right at the guy. Gotta watch your time, cause it's flying right by. Two-turn baby girl, you know me.
All right, so now that I'm done with the strawberries, I actually want us to give you guys a couple of tips. So I just wanted to give you a couple of tips that I wish that I had done better. So one thing is when I put the skewers into the strawberries, I probably should have dipped the skewer in the chocolate before I put it into the strawberry, because I noticed that the strawberries were kind of moving around a little bit on the skewers. So that's one thing that I would fix. The other thing is when you're doing the sanding sugar and the pearls too, you actually have to let the chocolate set a little bit because it adds weight to it. And if the chocolate is still like really melted, then it's actually going to just like fall right off. And I had that happen to me, but I ain't show y'all. So those are the tips that I have. So with the second batch of strawberries that I did off camera, I actually did that and it turned out a lot better. Thanks for watching my video, guys. If you're new to my channel, make sure you hit the subscribe button and turn on the bell for notifications too, so you'll know the next time I post a video. Leave a comment below, let me know what you thought of the strawberry bouquet, and let me know what other videos you guys want to see from me too. So until next time, bye.